Bonamassa, the great Tim Pierce, the great Jason Sinay, and me. And Joe said, throw me something out of my realm. Let's do archtops today. Right. So there it is right here. These guys never played together as a trio before. But when you got great players like that.
Or the Encino Guitar Trio.
Yeah, there you go.
The name's not has been taken yet. It's like mandolin. I can convince you for 30 seconds that I know what I'm doing. Like, wow, you really
can
play the mandolin.
You convinced me pretty damn good. Are you convinced?
Yeah, I got lost. I thought,
are you convinced?
I lost the one a couple times.
Too.
Well, yeah, you know, you never know what might happen over here. Joe, you just got back, can I say this, from Cuba?
From Cuba, yeah.
I went down. And you have a project you're going
to
do?
Well, you know, we went down there to scout out some Cuban musicians. And instead of doing what Ry Cooter did so well, many years ago when he went down there and basically sourced out the Buena Vista Social Club and found these great musicians that were school teachers and working other jobs. We're going to go down there this year and we're going to go armed with an electric guitar and some blues changes, you know? And see if we can, for lack of a better word, amalgamate the Cuban flavor with straight blues changes. And one of the most interesting exchanges we've had so far in the film, and we're going back in September, was through an interpreter. I said, hey, you know, are you guys familiar with the 1-4-5 change? And they're all very highly educated jazz musicians, and they go, sure, we can play 1-4-5. They started playing La Bamba. I'm like, okay, we may have some work to do. You know, and it's going to be this great cultural exchange project, and we're going to play with Cuban musicians to a Cuban audience, and it's going to be a highlight of my life. I mean, I always wanted to go down there and see what was going on, and you have to see Havana.
Some of those guys in Buena Vista are, you know, I remember those guys were terrific, and actually, when I was a kid, I was in Havana. Like maybe a month before Castro took over, it was Batista yeah. was in there, and it was like Las Vegas, man. Those hotels were absolutely gorgeous. There was gambling, there was the beautiful dancing girls. It was really unbelievably high end. And then, you know, from what I understand now, a lot of that hasn't been restored a lot and all that.
Well, the Riviera is still there. I think that was
Havana Riviera. That's where I stayed.
I think that was Lucky Luciano's place.
Yeah. Meyer Lansky
had the Nationale, and the great thing about it is for a collector, an antique guy, like you go in and you're seeing Art Deco stuff that was sourced originally and hasn't, like it wasn't like they went to an antique shop, they bought it new and it's still being used as a lamp and everything else.
A lot of 57 Chevys too down there.
Exactly. It's a wonderful place to go. It's a wonderful place to see. And to see the patina and you know, we're going to ruin it. You know that. Us Americans, we're going to ruin it. You know, but they're actually very excited to have some source of tourism income. And that's why, I mean, 5 years ago, 6 years ago, our trip down there would be very much more difficult than it is now.
So. Well, those Afro-Cuban rhythms and all that are so cool, and where bass players play are in different spots than where like the American or, you know, musicians
normally
play.
Everything's on the up.
Yeah. So it's really cool. And Timmy, what are you doing? You know, just to tell the audience about some of the stuff you got, your internet thing with Pete Thorne.
Yeah, I have a website where I teach now. I'm really excited about that. And I have a YouTube channel that I do every week that I'm really excited about. Still do sessions just about every day. Come down the hill, go to Pete's, come to Norm's.
There you go.
Pretty good life.
Yeah. And then we got Jason over here, my other brother over here. So we love Jason. He's family around here.
Thank you, buddy.
You're working on a pilot for a show. I don't know if we can talk about that yet.
Well, we'll see if it happens. Working on it, filming it. It's been a lot of fun. And about to launch a website and some new music that I've recorded in the studio. And I'm doing a little tour at the end of the summer. And been having a lot of fun with the whole social media thing. And trying not to let too many guitars creep into the house. And I'm losing that battle.
Who's going to shoot me or anything, right?
I'm a single man.
And Joe Sinead doesn't carry a gun or anything like that.
No, that's cheap. By the way, she encourages all purchases.
All right. That's well, awesome. that's Joe's girlfriend. She's beautiful from Australia, and she's really a sweet girl. But if she's carrying a gun, I might not be the place that I'd want to. You know, I'm a very big target. So anyhow, it's great having all you guys. It's like having some of the greatest guitar players in the world in my living room, right here at Norm's Rare Guitars. Could you guys play a little bit more, play us out, try something a little bit different, and you know, I'll let you impromptu eyes.
You start something.
I'm not starting anything. Thank you.
guitars come with a free tuner. Tuesdays only.
And you know what's remarkable?
We snark with every purchase.
You know what's remarkable about these guys here? When I first met them, I really wasn't sure if they all had the talent, but after the lessons I gave them, you guys have really come a long way.
That's been my secret. Thanks, Norm.
Thanks, Uncle Norm.
Right here, and then I woke up. Norm's Rag Guitars, the great Joe Bonamassa, the great Tim Pierce, the great Jason Sinay.